This is a copyrighted work. Unauthorized copying or distribution is a crime punishable by up to 5 years in prison and a fine of $250,000.
Scholastic Audio presents Dragon Masters, Book 3, Secret of the Water Dragon, by Tracey West, read by Emily Ellett. Before we start, while the Dragon Masters world is not the real world, many of the characters and places in it are inspired by real-world cultures. For this reason, I'll be pronouncing the names of these characters and places the way they'd be pronounced in the real world. These pronunciations may differ from how you think a name might sound based on its spelling alone. Chapter 1. Saddle Up.
"Steady now," warned Griffith, the king's wizard. "We have never tried putting a saddle on a dragon before. I'm not sure how she will like it."
Griffith and the dragon masters were in the training room, hidden beneath King Roland's castle. A magical stone called the Dragon Stone had chosen Drake, Beau, Rory, and Anna to work with dragons. Griffith was their teacher. The dragon masters stood around a big dragon with shiny blue scales.
"Beau, bring the buckle under Shoe's belly," Griffith said. "Now tighten the buckle. Good."
Drake watched his friend Beau put the saddle on Shoe. She was a water dragon, so she was usually very calm. Shoe stood still as Beau pulled the buckle tightly.
"Good job, Shoe," Beau said, patting her neck.
"Now can I put a saddle on Vulcan?" asked Rory.
"And can we please ride our dragons today, Griffith?" asked Anna.
"King Roland's crafters are making a saddle for each dragon," answered Griffith. "The other saddles will be ready tomorrow."
"Will there be a saddle for Worm?" asked Drake.
He looked over at his dragon. Worm was an earth dragon. He had a long body like a snake. He had no legs and tiny wings. Worm couldn't fly like the other dragons could.
"Yes, Worm has a very special power. He can take you from one place to another in the blink of an eye," Griffith said. "A saddle is a good idea for any type of travel."
Drake nodded.
"It is time for dinner," said Griffith. "Please put away your dragons and head to the dining room."
"Well, I hope I get to test Vulcan's saddle first tomorrow," Rory said. "Vulcan and I didn't get to do anything fun today."
She marched off toward the dragon caves. Her dragon, Vulcan, stomped after her. He was a fire dragon with red scales. Anna followed Rory. She skipped along. Her dragon, Kepri, moved like a graceful dancer beside her. Kepri was a sun dragon with a slim body and white scales. Drake helped Beau take off Shoe's saddle. They put their dragons in their caves. Then they took the stairs to the dining room in the tower. After dinner, the boys went to their room. Drake touched his dragon stone as they walked. Each of the dragon masters wore a piece of the stone. It let them connect with their dragons.
"Beau," Drake said, "do you think Worm can go anywhere in the world?"
"I think so," Beau said. "He has very strong powers."
Beau opened the door. Then he froze. Drake bumped into him.
"Beau, what's wrong?" Drake asked.
His friend was staring at his bed. His face looked pale. Drake followed his gaze. A black feather lay on Beau's pillow. Chapter 2. The Black Feather.
"That's strange," Drake said. "We must have left the window open."
Beau sat down on the bed and picked up the feather. He looked worried.
"Beau, it's just a feather," Drake said. "What's wrong?"
"Nothing. I am fine," Beau said.
But Drake didn't believe him. Beau was quiet as the boys climbed into bed. He rolled over and faced the wall.
Drake could tell that something was bothering Beau. But why would a feather upset him? Drake drifted off to sleep, thinking about his friend. I hope he's okay. When Drake woke up in the morning, Beau was sitting up in bed. He was wide awake.
Wow, have you been up a long time? Said Drake.
Beau shrugged.
I'm just excited to ride Shu today.
But Drake did not hear excitement in Beau's voice. The boys headed down to breakfast. Anna and Rory were already eating.
It's about time you two sleepyheads got here.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.